Friday night, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome, welcome, everybody. Welcome, everybody that's in the chat and everybody that's joining us. Tonight, we have a hell of a show for you because we have a couple exclusives. We got a world premiere for you to start it off. Yeah, what's up, Tay Boogie? Jesse, Elton, homie, don't play that. Jerry Lane checking in so far. I see you guys. I see you. And we'll be checking the chat and all that good stuff. I think you guys are going to love tonight's show. This show just keeps getting better and better each and every week because we keep finding more and more crazy shit. I mean, it's the internet. We can find all kinds of stuff, and we have found it. Shawnee Boy's got the Modelo count at 2, but I noticed that the Muskrat Moscato count is at 0, Shawnee Boy. What's up with that, sir? You're gonna have to do something there, sir. You're going to have to throw that up to 1 at least, Shawnee Boy. You got to catch up. Elton saying, let's go. So, anyways, welcome to the show, ladies and gentlemen. Here we go. We've got a world premiere for you that's happening. It's coming out April 1st. Cheers, AA. I see you. Shawnee Boy, go ahead and hit him with this world premiere. It's a movie that nobody should see. Leave Your Land Live, the musical, coming out April 1st, ladies and gentlemen. It's the absolute movie that nobody needs to see. Nobody needs to see it, but it's coming out. So it is Leave Your Land Live, the musical. Yes, this is a horror film. I suggest it is rated R. Do not take the kids to see this at all. And Zero Dark Tony checking in saying, is this a Pentecostal service? Of course it is, sir. We are in the middle of Lent. And I'm glad that you guys didn't give up replayables as your choice. Choreographer is Rob Saul. And that movie is coming out April 1st, Leave Your Land Live, the musical. It's the movie that nobody needs to see. Nobody needs to see. Yeah, that should be released 10/31. So yeah, it should for Halloween or what are you getting at there, Elton? I don't know. Shawnee Boy, go ahead and hit him with our next clip. It's a great clip sent to me by Mr. Jay Valentine. Jay Valentine is the man. He knows how to do things. So go ahead and hit him with that, Shawnee Boy.
Ice, ice, baby. All right, stop. Here's $1 million. I'm like, how much?
Get out of here. The acting career is coming out. I'll check it out on October 32nd. There you go, Tay Boogie. There you go, because that will be a great day to check out Leave Your Land the Musical. Yeah, the acting career is starting to explode a little bit, and so is the podcast career, ladies and gentlemen. But Leave Your Land the Musical live, check it out April 1st. And thank you, Mr. Jay Valentine. So save this autograph. That is correct, AA. I think I might have signed a couple things for you that way back in the day. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, it's Friday night. I hope you got your beers. I hope you got your whatever, your mixed drinks, your smokes, your left-handed cigarettes, whatever it is that you do on a Friday night. And I appreciate you for jumping in and checking out Replayables. And let's jump into the show, Shawnee boy. The first clip is called Message to Women. This is a message to women, so hit him with it, Shawnee boy.
I hope you're fucking comfortable laying in that bed.
I gotta go to fucking work, and it's freezing. I can't find my jacket, so I'm fucking pissed off. Bitches. We going shopping today, bitch. Fucker. Alright. I'm going to work. I love you.
I hope See, ladies, you don't know.
I gotta go to fucking work, and it's freezing. I can't find my jacket, so I'm pissed off.
You just don't know the sacrifices that we make. Especially when you're out shopping. Yeah. Get it, boy. Me every morning at 6 a.m. That is correct, AA, man. The ladies don't know. The ladies just don't know what we go through. The struggle is real. The struggle is real for everybody that has to get up early and go to work. So that is a message to women. And yes, that is the truth. Hope he remembered his keys. Homie, me too, because if not, he's in big trouble because he already forgot his coat. And hopefully his keys were not in his coat. That is a message to women around the world. Shawnee boy, this next clip was sent to us. It is Mad Much. Tay Boogie, I hope that after work he goes to anger management. I don't know. This next clip brought to us, ladies and gentlemen, is we're just gonna call it what it is. It's gay dogs. It's gay dogs. I mean, there's nothing else that you can say about it. Shawnee boy, show everybody in the Replayables world the gay dogs.
Here you go, Racky. I know how much you like wieners.
Rocky's a good dog.
This episode of How Gay Is My Dog. Here's a sausage, Bailey. Would you like it? No. No.
Here We're calling that dog Bailey.
Like wieners.
But realistically, that dog is probably Stevie Nicks. I don't know. Not the first dog. Not the first dog, but the second dog is probably definitely Stevie Nicks.
Here's a sausage, Bailey. Would you like it?
No.
No,
that dog's got to go.
No.
Here you go, Racky. I know how much you like wiener.
Yeah, so we're just calling it what it is. The second dog is a gay dog. I mean, obviously, we probably all know whose dog that is. Yes, Rocky is missing that peanut butter. The accent made it even better. I believe so. And we know that that accent was put on. It was fake, but whatever. That was gay dogs, ladies and gentlemen. So that was gay dogs. Keep the sausages out of that second dog's house. Milk bones, please. That is what that dog is saying, except for forget the milk. Just bring the bone. Yeah, that was our second clip, ladies and gentlemen. And Shawnee boy, in the Replayables world, we get sent a few things, man. So we're going to mix it up a little bit tonight. But there is a little theme. It's a little hidden theme. You guys will see it once we get about 10 clips deep. You'll pick up on what the theme is. But right now, we're going to hit you with some plain old soccer. Plain old soccer. You got to be careful when you're out there playing soccer and you're on defense because you never know what's coming at you. Plain old soccer, Shawnee boy. Plain old soccer, ladies and gentlemen. And who says soccer is not a tough sport? It's a very tough sport. Number 16 was short enough, he just winged it. I mean, that kid was okay. That's why we can play this clip. Nobody was harmed during the making of this Replayables video. I promise you. Is that legal to play? Yes, it is, because nobody was harmed during the making of this video. And that is why when people say soccer is not a real man sport or soccer is not tough, you got to look out because the defense is always got to be on point. I mean, number 16 just winged it and ducked it and missed it. So that was a great clip. Shawnee boy, we don't want to get a strike number two because we already got a strike and we were sent down. So that dude kick flipped by John Cena. Yes, he did. Where was the goalie? I don't know. I mean, he bailed. He bailed. See, even God hates soccer. Yes, that is true. That is true. And but I mean, those kids did a good job. The goalie actually got the ball at the end. Yes, he did. So therefore, the score is still 0-0. 0-0. Although the plane gets one for that. So the plane got one. I mean, that's what we're going to be watching this week, ladies and gentlemen. I'm glad you all have stopped by. So crack those drinks and relax and join us. Shawnee boy, hit them with a little. When you got to go, you got to go. Whoever gives this gift. Final Destination, Part 7. Not finished yet. When you got to go, you got to go. I mean, the kid just wanted to break in his birthday gift. It's a horrible gift. It's a shitty gift. He was just gonna break it in. I mean, I don't blame him. It's better than a gender reveal party, I guess. Absolutely better than a gender reveal party. So good for that kid. Good for that kid. I give him points. I give him points, Johnny boy. Yeah. So glad he didn't get the rectal thermometer. That is true, because that kid is too young to know the difference between a rectal thermometer and an oral thermometer, and everybody knows it's the taste. So if he would have got a rectal thermometer, he would have been in some shit. So I mean that was a terrible gift. Good for him for wanting to break it in, though, because I know every time we unwrap the gift when we were kids, we wanted to play with it right away too. So good for that kid. I think that kid gets bonus points, which is our next clip, Shawnee boy. Bonus points. Bonus points. He landed on his feet eventually. He landed on his feet, so he definitely gets some bonus points off of this one, in my book. Yeah, he did not get hurt, so he landed on his feet. That is definitely some bonus points, for sure, for him. But I believe that guy also had great karma. And that is our next clip, Shawnee boy. Good karma. Play it for him. The last guy had good karma. This guy's got bad karma. It's what you get. It's what you get for trying to take those Amazon packages. He needed to do a team lift on this one. A team lift. And he would have been okay. Nope. I love it. I absolutely love it. I'm going to grease my steps. Yeah, glad. Yeah, I'm going to grease my steps just in case somebody wants to do this. Although I don't get any packages, so that would be even more, that would be more hilarious to see somebody come up on my porch and try to walk away because they're going to go down like this. Yeah. Then the taser peeks out the door. It zaps the guy. There you go, Shawnee boy. And then he goes home and he's like, I've had a bad day. I've had a bad day. Instant karma is the best karma. I believe in it and I love it. And it couldn't have happened to a better person. When Amazon ties fish string to him. Yeah, that's a good idea, AA. Put a little fish string, anchor it in the door. And then when the porch pirates come, this is what happens. They go down. Yeah. He killed every lie for the future, and he didn't make it home. I hope so, Tay Boogie. I hope so, man, because he gets what you get rewarded what you put in, though. There you go. That guy is definitely off to a rocky start. The Rob House. Yes, yes, Nixon. Yes, that is true. The Rob House. So I wish that would happen to Rob. No, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. I love the guy. He was just getting off to a rocky start. So, Shawnee boy, show him a little rocky start before we got to take a commercial break. Aye. Rocky start. Aye. Guy's definitely a GoPro. Aye. This is the guy that took the packages. He was on his way home. Yeah, love that front flip. I give him a 9 for that. I give him a 9 for that flip, baby. So I must have some good karma. Yeah. Oh, you just got an email saying you're a winner. There you go, Shawnee boy. Yeah, you must have good karma. Hopefully that Nigerian prince works out for you and gives you those millions of dollars, sir. So make sure that you send them your social security card and everything else that they need in order to ship you your money, Shawnee boy. So that is some good karma right there. I think that it was the guy that stole the packages off the porch and he was on his way home. Dirt bike guy having a hard time. Absolutely. he wasn't ready to remove the training wheels. So yeah, he might be using that potty that the kid got in the earlier clip. Shawnee boy, at this point in the show, Replayables has been doing so well week after week. We are actually picking up some great sponsors for the show, so that way we can continue bringing you guys this show, because there's a little bit of cost involved. And we didn't mind fronting that cost in the beginning, because we know that we've got a good show and we love making people laugh on a Friday night that are hanging out with us. So anyways, we have had some sponsors call us and they want to sponsor the show. Well, in turn, since we take their money, we have to run their commercials. But we do screen our sponsors. We screen our sponsors, and we only bring you the best sponsors in the world for Replayables, ladies and gentlemen. And tonight, our biggest sponsor of the show is... This Modelo is for you, sir. And by saying that, Shawnee boy, raise that Modelo count up to 3, sir. I got Muppet assistance. Yes, it seems legit. James Nixon, say what? So, sense of humor lost, says Jerry Lane. Fair is fair. That is true. Good evening, folks. Just got here. Oh, that's too bad, Kish Kish, because you just missed a word from our sponsor. But that's okay, because you can catch up later, sir, and I appreciate you joining us. Shawnee boy, let's jump on to our next clip. Flipping out on friends. Flipping out on friends. You should, Jones, conduct the wedding. Yes, I should, Elton. This is flipping out on friends, ladies and gentlemen. His feet must have stank. She does not like athlete's foot. Oh my God, I can't even believe he got back up and ran to her. So that guy's insecure. I would have been like, nope. Either that or I would have ran back to her and been like, okay, your turn. Let's see how this goes for you. You know what? Never trust a guy with a man bun anyways. So never trust a guy that has a man bun. So I think she did absolutely correct by doing that. Taz checking in. Mr. Abels, Mr. Kish, homie, Shawnee, Mr. Nixon, and everyone. Taz checking in. 140 viewers. Thank you, Jerry Lane. Taz, man. Taz, the resident artist, ladies and gentlemen, has a hell of a talent, man. She's been drawing up tons of pictures and stuff and sent me some. And we appreciate you, Taz. You are absolutely amazing. Yeah, dude had Taco Bell before the tryouts. I believe so, AA. But once you got a whiff of those feet, man, kick me in the face and you're getting dropped. That's right, homie. Shawnee boy, run that one more time, because I don't know if everybody caught the man bun and the feet that was happening. So let's see what happens here. His feet stank. His feet stank. I don't blame her. Don't blame her. I'm telling you, I would have tossed him. I would have tossed him. He deserved that. So he absolutely deserved that. That is flipping out on friends, ladies and gentlemen. But this also leads us into our next clip, because I told you guys there's a little theme that's happening. The next clip, Shawnee boy, is called Chivalry Isn't Dead. Chivalry is not dead. Told you, chivalry isn't dead. He just. I hope the camera caught that. Are you okay? No. He kept walking too.
Are you okay? No. Are you okay? No.
Chivalry isn't dead, ladies and gentlemen. I tell you, man, because first of all, he said, are you okay? She said, no. And he also asked her, or he said, I hope the camera caught that. And I do too, because that made a great Replayables clip. So I hope the camera caught that. Chivalry isn't dead. They are definitely married. 100% AA. You nailed it. You can tell because he just kept walking. He just kept walking after that. Yeah. Sports head ran long. That's okay. Lost interest. That's okay, man. You said you're late. Sports heads ran long. Check out Sports Heads on the Shuley Network, ladies and gentlemen. Every Friday night it goes on prior to Replayables. And we appreciate everybody at the Shuley Network that is joining us. So better late than never. That's what I say, lost interest. And you think you're late, sir, but you're just in time. That is spousal neglect and harassment, and but also entertainment, correct? And if anybody has any problem with the harassment or the neglect, you can call our boy Jonesy. But Shawnee boy, let's jump into the triple Lindy. Triple Lindy.
Somebody.
Thank you, Jerry.
Oof. Somebody.
Triple Lindy. Somebody had a bad day. Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's what you get for trying to show off there, man. You get triple Lindy, baby. That's why I stay away from pools. I'm not going into Levy's pool because I can see some shit happening like this going down in Levy's pool as soon as he gets it. Actually, that might have been Bob Levy. Run that one more time, Shawnee boy. That very well might have been Bob. Let's take a look at it.
Somebody.
Bam.
Somebody. Somebody.
I guarantee that's going to happen at Levy's pool party. So, yeah, reverse belly flop. Yeah, I've heard of a belly smacker, but this is ridiculous. Absolutely. And this is probably will go down at Levy's pool party, and I'm not going to do it. So, Shawnee boy said that's me, so we will let Shawnee boy do that. So, I appreciate everybody. And the back flop. There you go, Lost C. You said you're late, but you're never late, sir. You're always on time. It's all about timing. Jonesy surgery commercial coming up next, correct, Jerry Lane? Jonesy will jump in. Hey, Kathy, checking in. So, Rip Sean, we always love you. So, they'll always love you, Shawnee boy, no matter what, if you do those backflips or not. Guys, the Modelo count is approaching 4, Shawnee boy. It's approaching 4, sir. So, go ahead and chalk that up to 4. And I can't feel my spine. I can't feel my spine. Modelo count's at 4, sir. We've hit the point of the show, ladies and gentlemen. It's time to drop some knowledge on you. I think you guys know what time it is. Let me see it in the chat. I think you guys know what time it is. So first person that says it, well, you're the first person that says it. There's no prize tonight until Jonesy gives us some prizes. Shawnee boy, it's that time in the show. Muskrat time. Yeah, close, Shawnee boy. Close, very close. It's llama time, ladies and gentlemen. It is llama time. Shawnee boy, hit him with a little llama time.
Llamas are members of the camelid family, meaning they're pretty closely related to vicunas and camels. Camelids first appeared on the central plains of North America about 40 million years ago. About 3 million years ago, llamas' ancestors migrated to South America. During the last ice age, 10,000 to 12,000 years ago, camelids went extinct in North America. Now there are around 160,000 llamas and 100,000 alpacas in the United States and Canada. Llamas were first domesticated and used as pack animals 4,000 to 5,000 years ago in the Peruvian highlands. Llamas can grow as much as 6 feet tall, though the average llama between 5 feet 6 inches and 5 feet 9 inches tall. Llamas weigh between 280 and 450 pounds and can carry 25 to 30% of their body weight, so a 400-pound male llama can carry about 100 to 120 pounds on a trek of 10 to 12 miles with no problem.
Llamas love to watch RePlay Ables and Levy Land.
Llamas are members of the camelid family, meaning they're pretty closely related to vicunas and camels. Camelids first appeared on the central plains of North America about 40 million years ago. About 3 million years ago, llamas' ancestors migrated to South America. During the last ice age, 10,000 to 12,000 years ago, camelids went extinct in North America. Now there are around 160,000 llamas and 100,000 alpacas in the United States and Canada. Llamas were first domesticated and used as pack animals 4,000 to 5,000 years ago in the Peruvian highlands. Llamas can grow as much as 6 feet tall, though the average llama between 5 feet 6 inches and 5 feet 9 inches tall. Llamas weigh between 280 and 450 pounds and can carry 25 to 30% of their body weight, so a 400-pound male llama can carry about 100 to 120 pounds on a trek of 10 to 12 miles with no problem.
Llamas love to watch RePlay Ables and Levy Land.
We are back, ladies and gentlemen. James Nixon saying, is this a restroom break? Absolutely, sir. It's not just a restroom break. It's a knowledge break. And homie saying, we are all llama experts, but are absolutely clueless about muskrats. That is true, homie. That is true. So Shawnee Boy needs to drop in a little muskrat, Moscato information for everybody. Back in my day, we ate llamas. I see that, Shawnee Boy. I see you, sir. But yeah, ladies and gentlemen, we hope your llama knowledge is up. And Shawnee Boy, in the future, we got to get some muskrat information so that way we can do yours, sir. Let's get right back into the show, ladies and gentlemen. Let's get right back into the show because we're having a great time tonight. So I salute you. I salute you guys. Thank you all for checking in with Replayables and our new sponsor, Jonesy, and our old sponsor, Silk City Hot Sauce. Go to silkcityhotsauce.com, enter code REPLAY, get 15% off all your delicious hot sauces because summer is coming, ladies and gentlemen. So jump on that. Enter code REPLAY, you get 15% off, and you always get bonus stuff in your package. Shawnee Boy, let's jump back into the clip, sir. Beer pong, anyone? Beer pong, anyone?
Oh, that was not the right way to do that.
That's not how you play beer pong. What's the news on Levy Land? Jerry Lane, we will be back on Wednesday.
Are you okay?
Don't tell anybody, but I heard Muskrat Moscato Count is coming next week. There you go.
Are you okay?
That's not how you play beer pong.
Oh my God, that was not the right way to do that.
Nobody told him to bring the ping pong balls. Nobody told him to bring the ping pong balls. That's how you play beer pong, not that way. I mean, he thought if he jumped into the cups, everybody else would have to take a shot. Wrong, sir. That's how you do it. That's not how you do it. Rage quit. Yeah, there you go. There you go. He was like, game's over. I'd hate to see this guy play cornhole. I'd hate to see him play cornhole. So the news on Levy Land, Jerry, is we are back on Wednesday. So wait, what was the right way to do that? Shawnee Boy, I will teach you when you come up in April, sir. I will teach you how to play beer pong. Maybe I'll tell you that's how you play. I don't know. He watched too many cartoons and on diving into a glass of water. That is correct, homie. That is absolutely correct. So you get the bell on that one. Yeah, he's been watching way too many cartoons. He didn't know this is how you just beat it. Shawnee Boy, just beat it. That it. Kill that music, Shawnee. Kill that music before we get a copyright. Yeah. He did not know. He was trying to do Michael Jackson to Guns N' Roses. Never works out. So welcome to the jungle, baby. Now you meet the floor. Now you meet the floor. That is why we call that. Just beat it. Just beat it. Ooh, there he goes. There he goes, ladies and gentlemen. So that is the Axel pose. And he just went down. So yeah, you know why? I know why. Because this guy is not a gymnast. He's not a gymnast. He should take some advice from our next man. The man would never survive in the jungle. That is correct. Should have played. Let's just hit the floor. Let the bodies hit the floor. Yeah. That would have been the song that he should have played, because then that would have been a great dance move. So your guest last week was a fun birthday boy. That is correct, Jerry. And he had an absolute blast. That is one of Replayable's biggest fans, man. And he kept telling me, he kept saying, all I want for my birthday is to be on Replayables. So we were so happy to make E-Dub's birthday wish come true. So the coolest guy in the trailer park. Exactly, Elton. That is the coolest guy in the trailer park. He was so proud of himself, too. Yes, he was. E-Dub did an amazing job sitting in with me on Replayables. We'd love to do that for you guys, man. Anytime one of you fans would like to join me on Replayables, the direction that we were going is, if you guys would like to join me on Replayables, sit in with me for a couple clips, we can always send you a link and bring you in, and you can sit in with us on a couple clips because we love to give back to you guys. So that's just what we love to do. So anybody that ever wants to jump in and sit in some clips, message me. You can find me at Chris Abels Fool on Twitter, Chris_Abels on Instagram, Comedian Chris Abels on Facebook, Replayable67 on Twitch. So just hit us up, ladies and gentlemen, because you guys send us some of the dopest clips, and I love bringing you guys on the show. If you want to come on the show, you can join us each and every week. And now that we got a sponsor, we might even be able to pay you a little something. We got to talk to our attorney, Jonesy, through his cheap ass legal and daycare academy. But I think that we can make that happen. We might have to make you sign a waiver, though. I'm not sure. I do know this next person is not a gymnast. They're definitely not a gymnast. So hit him with it, Shawnee boy. Not a gymnast. Looks like a gymnast, just not a gymnast. So is there audio on this one, Shawnee boy? Oh, man, I wish there was audio on this one because I'd love to hear what he said after he did his. I don't even know what you call that. I don't even know what that move is called, Shawnee boy. It's not the monkey bars, although it looks like the monkey bars. Yeah, would be tough to match E-Dub's appearance. That is true, Lost. It would be tough to match E-Dub's appearance. Oh, my God. He almost went into the outhouse on this one is what he did. I wish he would have. That would have been great. The upside down Spider-Man. That is the move. Perfect landing. Exactly. Perfect landing. Thank God it was a chain link fence. Training for beer pong. Ooh, good call, AA. Training for beer pong. Guys, I gotta get ready. I gotta get ready for beer pong. Yeah, yeah, that is the training grounds for beer pong. Exactly, exactly, AA. Nailed it. Nailed it on that one. So I give it a 9.5. Homie says I give it a 9.5. I give him an 8 just because he buckled at the end there. Run it one more time, Shawnee boy, so you can watch the end. If he would have kept the toes up, I would have given him the 9. So he needed to point the toes, exactly. So, yeah, he did, but then he gave up at the end, and so I gave up on him, and I give him an 8. I give him an 8. Shawnee boy, let's jump into our next clip, sir, called Just Kicking It. Just Kicking It. Just kicking it. Long day for Mr. Kish Kish. I'm glad you're relaxing watching replayables, sir. Just kicking it. Just kicking it, baby. Yeah. You gotta check yourself before you wreck yourself, baby. Mm. Yeah, man. Yeah. When you learn Kung Fu from YouTube, this is what you get. This is what you get. Shawnee boy, you gotta end that before they give us a hi-ya. Yeah. When you learn Kung Fu from YouTube, this is what you get. I tried to fix a car from YouTube. It didn't work out. So if you knew the enemy and knew yourself, you not fear the end result. Hundreds of battles. And if you know yourself, God, enemy. Okay, Shawnee boy. Surfer defeated. That was a paragraph. Can someone help me find my eyeball after that? Yes, he deserved that. He absolutely deserved that. So, Shawnee boy, let's hit him. Everybody knows that DMX was the hardest rapper, but I don't know if you guys know his brother, BMX. He was the hardest rider. Sun Tzu. So DMX was the hardest rapper out there. BMX is his brother, and he was the hardest bike rider. Shawnee boy, let's hit him with BMX, the hardest rapper. I'll tell you what was hardcore about this. The lady in the background, she did not give any fucks. She just kept walking. She did not even care. She did not even care. This is why you got to be careful when you have pegs and shocks on your bike, Napoleon. Now that kid deserves a 9.5 for the twist, the turn, and the shirt. So, Art of War. Shawnee boy's too smart for me. BMX. What you really want? What you really want? Yeah, when your bike gives up on you. It's called the wedgie. That was amazing. I love that. That kid's got some good tricks, man. Bootleg Sons of Anarchy. Yeah. So, yeah, Bootleg Sons of Anarchy. He's going to be, from that crash, he's going to be the Sons of Arthritis. I'm telling you. God bless that shirt. Exactly. Shirt saved his fall. It did. Yes, it did. Lost. It absolutely did. That kid got lucky. He got lucky in many ways. But the lady in the background, she just did not even care. If I seen that, I'd be like, oh, shit. Not her. She just kept going about her business. She just kept going about her business. So that's when that leads us into our next clip, Shawnee Boy. It's called Lights On, Lights Out. Lights On, Lights Out. Hit him with it, Shawnee Boy.
Ready?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Let's go.
Lights on, lights out.
Mm-hmm.
Lights on, lights Let's out. Go. Let's go.
Ready?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Let's go.
There you go, baby. That's probably the worst way to turn on the lights. Lights on, lights out. Tonight's theme is brought to you by Drunken Masters of Comedy, coming March 17th to Martinsburg, West Virginia. Me, Tay Boogie, and Jay Brooks, baby. The Drunken Masters of Comedy. So tonight's theme is the karate. He should have messed in a clapper. Yes, he should. Not too bright. Exactly. Not too bright on that one. I'm calling Nate to install a kick switch for me. There you go. One piece represent. There you go, Taz. Yeah. Lights on, lights off, ladies and gentlemen. Shawnee Boy. Now that Replayables has a sponsor, unfortunately, we've got to do two commercials for our sponsor during the show. Although we love our sponsor. Our sponsor is Jonesy. Jonesy is an entrepreneur. So Jonesy doesn't just have his cheap-ass prepaid legal and daycare academy. And Shawnee Boy, that takes this into our next clip, which is Weight on His Shoulders. We put the weight on his shoulders. It's what you get for trying to show off. He filled in the neighborhood in Detroit. Yeah. Bro, you're supposed to put the weight on his shoulders. On your shoulders. Best sponsor ever. Yes, Jess. Yes, Jonesy. In a food commercial was hilarious. Yes, we also have that coming up, Jerry Lane. It won't be on this week because Jonesy only wants us to run a couple a week, but Jonesy will be back with us next week because he's one of our proud sponsors. He is very trustworthy. So this is no weight on his shoulders. No weight on his shoulders. Sternum snap. Oh, yeah, that's a huge weight on his chest, though. Yeah, exactly. So that's what he gets for trying to be a show-off, Shawnee Boy. You can't be a show-off in the gym. All these people go to the gym, and they want to show off. Look at what I can lift, bro. Yeah, until the weight's on your shoulders or the weight's on your chest, the way that went down with him. So, Shawnee Boy, this next one, sometimes Replayables doesn't like to get political, but we do get great clips every now and then, and this next one is a Biden impression. Biden impression, Shawnee Boy. Hit him with it. This is a Joe Biden impression. Motherfucking shoes untied.
Man, why you ain't help him up?
Shit, I just got back in town, man. How the hell I supposed to know he was going to hang
out? Why didn't you help him up? I just got back into town. Run that one more time, Shawnee Boy.
Oh, shit.
Hit that man a stair stepper.
You alright, Dad?
Motherfucking shoes untied, man.
Yeah, he's not a Stairmaster. Exactly.
Man, why you ain't helping him?
He'll get it one day.
Shit, I just got more back of a trip. Town, man. How the hell I supposed to know he was gonna hang on my
More of a treadmill kind of guy, so he's normal. He fell down and not up. Yeah, that is true. That is true. So that is absolutely true. So that was a terrible Biden impression, but he did have the falling part down. So I will give him that. I will give him that. This next clip, ladies and gentlemen, as our night rolls on, is called Grandma's Excited. Grandma's Excited. Hit him with it, Shawnee boy. Gender news, and that really did happen to somebody's grandma. Stephen Bull, by the title of the show tonight, I got confused. I thought this was going to be about hip-hop. No, Steamboat. It's a hip-hop hooray. Ho, we're watching Grandma go down. Grandma said, we're having surgery. We're not just having a boy. We're having surgery. There you go. Hey. A life for a life. Exactly, Taz. When I watched that clip earlier, I was just like, well, one's coming in, one's going out. She didn't have to fall for it. Yeah. She definitely did not have to fall very far at all. So, Shawnee boy, let me see Grandma go down one more time. I kind of like this clip. I'm sick like that. To the grandma ounce. So, all this next clip, guys, I love this. My granny fell down 3 flights of stairs, and she died. Oh, sorry to hear that, Stephen Bull. So, she never made it to a gender reveal party. That's terrible. That is absolutely terrible. But that's okay. She would love replayables, and I'm sure she's watching it in heaven, sir. So, Shawnee boy, let's jump on to our next clip. The ping pong judge. I love this next ping pong judge. Broken hip. Ha. There we go. Keep an eye on the judge. Keep an eye on the judge as this goes down. I love it. I absolutely love it. So she just got written out of the will. Yeah, I love this. I love the judge. Who knew being a judge at a ping pong game came with dangers? Came with danger. I think this was blatant. I think they were behind, and he just took it out on the judge. So I think he took it out on the judge. Thank you, Stephen Bull. She would watch replayables. I appreciate you saying that, sir. And I hope Grandma put you in the will. But yeah, that ping pong judge, man, I'm thinking that the pink team was a little bit behind. They didn't like a couple calls. I don't know what the calls are in ping pong, but I think he was taking it out on the judge. Run it one more time, Shawnee boy. I didn't think you could paddle anymore. It tells me it was a setup because the guy in the blue team was already over there to pick the judge up. I love it. I didn't think he could paddle anymore. Exactly. I love it because he went right after the judge. Judges are not safe in any game whatsoever. Shawnee boy, let's hit him with the next clip called Rep. Oh, it's ripped. Ripped. There you go. Ripped. Just over here getting ripped. I'm going to start going to the gym and doing this. Bluetooth, bam, bam. If this is the results at the gym, I'm going to go do this because this is great. I love it. I love it that she's so vain. Her and the other chest press guy should work out together. They would be a great couple. They would be an absolutely great couple. Sonny boy, I know why you like this clip. I know why you like this clip. Yeah, she was asking for it wearing that exactly, homie. I believe so. And that dude, I love that dude because he totally set her up. But her and chest press guy should work out together because I think they would be a great couple. Sonny boy, that takes us on to our next clip, man. This next clip is called Married Life. Married Life.
Here we are in the hotel room of a newlywed couple on their honeymoon.
Yes, and this actually happened to her before, yeah.
For bed, and the husband throws the wife his pants. He goes, put these on.
Is there a fire?
So she gets up, she tries to put them on, but the waistband is way too big. She goes, I can't wear your pants. And he said, that's right. Just remember, I'm the man, and I wear the pants in this family. All of a sudden, she throws her panties at him. She goes, here, try these on. He tries to put them on, and they only go up to his knees. He goes, hell, I can't get in your panties. She goes, that's right, and that's the way it's going to be until you change your fucking attitude.
Oh, you know that's a couple from New York. That is a couple from New York.
They start to get undressed for bed, and the husband throws the wife his pants. He goes, put these on. So she gets up, she tries to put them on, but the waistband is way too big. She goes, I can't wear your pants. And he said, that's right. Just remember, I'm the man, and I wear the pants in this family. All of a sudden, she throws her panties at him. She goes, here, try these on. He tries to put them on, and they only go up to his knees. He goes, hell, I can't get in your panties. She goes, that's right. And that's the way it's going to be until you change your fucking attitude.
Oh, that is definitely a New York couple. So I don't get it, Stephen Bull. You gotta follow the show, sir, and then you'll get it. You'll get it. Jump in from the beginning, and you'll be with us from the jump, and then you'll understand what's happening on Replayable, sir. We got one more clip for you, ladies and gentlemen, before we take this show out of here. Shawnee Boy, I say go ahead and jump. Go ahead and jump. Go ahead and jump. I love it. Go ahead and jump, baby. Don't go making mountains out of molehills. So what if he got him on? Exactly. Yeah, he should have done it. My dad told me the same thing when I was a child. Go ahead and jump. Go ahead and jump. Exactly. So Staten Island, that is where that couple was from. Tay Boogie recognized the accent. So Tay Tay knew where that accent came from on that couple that was married. Shawnee Boy, did Jay Valentine send us another clip, sir? Run Jay Valentine's clip. His hopes were higher than his jump. Yeah, that's how I feel on Friday nights, ladies and gentlemen. This is exactly how I feel. You guys make my week each and every week, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, that's how I feel, because you guys make my week each and every week. I always look forward to Tuesdays and Wednesdays, now Wednesday nights for Levy Land, and then for Replayables on Friday nights. So Jay Valentine made that for me. Got to commit to the jump. Exactly, Lost Interest, man. I love you guys for checking in with us each and every week. We try to bring you a dope show, and we hope that you guys have fun. And so hit him one more time with the Jay Valentine clip, Shawnee Boy. I cannot see it, and I wish I could, but no, you don't. New show opener, that is correct. Hit him with it, Shawnee Boy. What in the Brokeback Mountain? Yeah, baby, Replayables. You are the boss, my friend. Thank you, Steve Bull. I love you, man. I love you guys, man. Cheers. You guys have a great weekend, man. Be safe. Have fun out there. Terry Need checking in, man. So I love you guys, man. We'll see you next week on Replayables. I love you guys for checking in with us, and we hope that we made your Friday night a replayable night. So peace out, ladies and gentlemen. We'll see you soon.